For his reaction, let's now have Gus Lagman. He's a former Comelec commissioner and chairman of the National Citizens Movement for Free Elections. Good afternoon, Mr. Lagman, and thanks for being on the show.
Good afternoon, Stan.
All right, F2 Logistics by Dennis Uy, bagging this contract despite his close association with President Duterte, although Comelec is saying donating to a candidate's campaign is not a ground for disqualification. Now, is this all right with you, or don't you think the Commission on Elections should have exercised more prudence in choosing a supplier?
Well, I think prudence dictates that you don't give it to one who's a major contributor to your election campaign. So this, things like this should not happen. I mean, what has happened to delicadeza in the administration of our government? This is something that should be happening. A major contributor getting a major contract? Well,
but to your recollection, yes, Mr. Lagman, go ahead.
Add taste in the mouth. Again.
To your recollection, has this ever happened before?
Well, I'm sure that these things have happened in the past, but that doesn't make that right. Big campaign contributors would get major contracts from the administration that they helped get elected. As I said earlier, it leaves a very bad taste in the mouth, even assuming that there's nothing illegal about it.
Okay, F2 Logistics is said to have offered the lowest prices among the other suppliers. Is it just all about the price?
No, you have to look at the capability, the technical capability of the companies as well. Mm-hmm. That's why there is the technical and the financial capability of the companies who are bidding for a contract. Now, it just so happens that there's only one bidder. Now, whether the others were discouraged, the other prospective bidders were discouraged or not, I don't really know.
Okay, election watchdog Contradaya and several others from various sectors are of course calling for the cancellation of the delivery contract with F2, citing this undermines the 2022 elections. What is your view on this? What could happen and what could go wrong if this proceeds?
Well, it can undermine the election because the one who's going to deliver the materials is a major contributor of one of the political parties. It doesn't. What if they change the contents of the delivery truck? There is that danger. They should have given it to another supplier, another service provider.
Okay, so since this supply is, it's already in the works, how can the Comelec ensure F2 will deliver efficient service, considering many of the tasks under the contract are vital and critical?
If I were the Comelec, I would repeat it. I would consider it a failed bidding, rebid it, so that and invite other vendors, other service providers to participate in the bidding. I mean, if I had my way, that's what I would do.
Yes, and Mr. Lagman, is there a way to contest this?
Well, the one who can contest this would be losing bidders, but there are no other bidders. I think they might have been discouraged to participate. And that's the problem. It's unfortunate that these things happen in our government. It discourages other legitimate service providers. when these things happen.
Okay, on the part of the public, is there a way to monitor the performance of this supplier? I mean, you speak for the National Citizens Movement for Free Elections yourself in terms of surveillance, in terms of monitoring, and making sure the processes work given these circumstances. What would NAMFREL do?
Well, it'd be... Well, aside from... You see, our job is to make sure that elections are honest, peaceful, fair. But this is outside that. This is delivery. Of course, we also take a look at these things. In fact, even the printing of ballots, for example, we observe those activities. But we can only do so much because we don't have unlimited resources. But we do ask to be invited so that we can observe all the activities involved in an election process. Like I said, even during the printing of the ballots and other materials, we're there already. So we're hoping that we can be invited to observe this activity.
All right. On that note, thanks a lot, Mr. Gus Lagman, former Comelec Commissioner and Chairman of NAMFREL. Thank you, sir.
Okay. You're welcome.